In this video series, we continue to learn how to turn AI-generated model into game-ready. And today, we're talking about texturing. I'll show you how to paint model, fix imperfections, edit texture, and my favorite one, how to project any image on 3D object texture. Let's get started. We don't need anything but Blender. So in the previous video, we just baked the texture like a normal and color map. And now, we'll continue editing it. So before we started, I also did one more thing. I joined eye and teeth texture in an object called eyes_teeth. It's easy to do. Just select two objects with shift and press Ctrl J on a keyboard and it will join in one object. Let's move on. So first, let's review what artifacts do we have. So we're gonna start with eyes. As you remember, we created a sphere. So let's select sphere. Let's go to texture paint mode. Then we will extend the window by dragging the bottom left corner like this. Here we're gonna select shader editor. Let's go back to object mode. Now we're gonna need to create a new texture. You can press shift A on our empty space and create image texture. Then let's name it like IT's color and let's connect it to base color. If you wonder how I created the material, I basically pressed plus and the default material that it creates, it looks like this. Now we can go back to texture paint and we can select the brush. Let's first select fill. Let's select a white color. Let's press on any surface and it will fill it with the color that we selected. Let's do one more thing and let's extend the window and make it image editor. We will select paint mode and we will select the texture that we just created. You can easily use wheel to navigate and scale things. But guys, if you missed my first episode, I'm explaining there about simple controls in Blender. So check it out if you're struggling with the controls. It will be very simple. It will take just a few minutes for you to get acquainted. Now we're gonna make eyes with some brushes. So first, let's use paint hard pressure. Select a dark color. With pressing F, let's select a correct size. So we can paint it in 3D or in 2D. Let's select the right size and let's try to actually drop it in the very middle. Boom. Just one click and we have eye base. Because our eyes are mirrored, this one side is actually duplicated on both. Now let's select secondary color. So it will be a dark blue, a little bit greenish. Okay, let's choose a paint soft pressure. Make it a little bit smaller with F. And let's try to press it somewhere in the middle. Yes, like that. So we can press it like a few times. And we have some nice transition. Now let's make it a little bit lighter. With the smaller brush, press it once in the middle. Okay, let's go back to paint hard pressure. Let's select the dark color again. Make the radius smaller with F again. And press it once again in the middle. I think now just a little bit more. Oh, yes. Of course, the eye color is up to you. But I like this one. All right. And now when it's ready, the final touch will be adjusting roughness setting. So here in PBR material, we'll significantly reduce roughness. And here we go. Look at this. I will Ctrl Z on a texture and make the center part a little bit smaller. There are plenty of ways to do eyes, but I made it this way. Whenever you actually finish texturing, don't forget to go to image and actually save the image. Press save as, or if it's already saved, you can press Ctrl S. And the teeth will basically be white. That's totally fine. Guys, before we continue, first, there are more episodes to watch. And second, these videos are only possible thanks to your support. So hit the like button when we hit 200 likes. I'm starting to work on the next one right away. Now let's take a look on the body. We're gonna first go to object mode. We're gonna select body, which is like base low mesh. Go to texture mode again. First, let's review what we're gonna change. First of all, there are artifacts after baking. Yeah, especially area around the eyes, because we changed the eyes completely. We'll definitely paint it out. The area around mouse, the pattern here, it messes up a little bit with the normal. Yeah, the line here is not good enough. We can adjust it. Some artifact on the bottom and lines in front as well. Other than that, it's not that bad. So let's get started. To maximize, minimize any window, you can press Control Spacebar, and to minimize it back, also Control Spacebar. Let's start working only with color texture. And to do that, you can Shift Control left mouse button on the texture. In our case, it's Dyna Color. It will be connected to material output, so we can see the texture alone without any light effects, without normal map and stuff, and we can working with it. You can do that for any texture you're working on, and you can paint not only color texture but normals in other maps. Okay, so let's use clone texture first. So let's start with the top spike, and let's try use clone brush first. So with shift and right mouse button, you'll basically select an area that will be used as source, and then we can actually start cloning the area. So it basically will copy texture from the area we selected with shift right click. We can choose a brush a little bit less. So you can see when I try to paint, I accidentally touch the spike, which I don't want. So to make it easier, let's press tab to go into edit mode. We're gonna press L on the keyboard and select UV. And because we did a nice UV, I can use UV to select the whole head part like this, or you can manually select polygons. We're gonna back to texture mode, and we can activate this paint mask. So what's gonna happen is that we are only allowed to paint on the area that is selected to edit mode, which is great. And now I can easily correct all these artifacts. Use the clone brush. Okay, let's maybe make it like a little bit less hard. And I will go through all of them similar way. Here is the result. I just painted around with the clone brush. And you can see it's not perfect like this. We can use smear brush to easily fix that. That will basically melt some stuff around. Okay, look at this. Just simple touches in the area that look inconsistent. And if you work with symmetrical model, don't forget that you in texture mode, you can also enable symmetry. So in this case, it will save you a little bit time if you're fixing the same artifacts from both sides. And don't forget disable it when you don't really need it. I just went to edit mode, selected back. And here we can actually fix these artifacts without the clone brush. We can just use smear brush and just like to sort of push these artifacts inside, and it will melt it really nice. Okay, now when I'm done with the body part, we're gonna fix artifacts on spikes. To do so, let's again go to edit mode. With L, let's select our spikes. You see, in my case, it's still selected UV because I have nice UV. If you don't have UV, only sharps, you can use sharps. But in the worst case, you can just select polygons. That will also do the job. Okay, I'm selecting them. That's right. Now let's go back to texture mode, choose paint mask. We can use smear brush again to simply reduce these artifacts as easy as it can be. Okay, so it took me 5 minutes, and you can see all spikes are perfectly painted with nice texture. And let's disable paint mask, and I will use smear to also smoothen the transition here, as it looks a little bit too strong and I see the polygons. So we're gonna use just a little bit, touch it around, and you can see it sort of make a nice transition. Now it looks smoother, and we can repeat this action all across the spikes. Look at this. Now the eyes. First, let's go to object mode and hide our eyes. Pressing on the eye button, go to texture mode while body object is selected. Let's use a normal brush, select the paint soft. We can actually choose the color same way in Photoshop or any other software. We can pick the color. Let's first go edit mode, enable mask, so we only paint on the head. Or maybe you can do that without it. With smaller brush, let's just paint it around. So I'll do darker the upper part, a bit lighter color from here to paint the bottom part. Okay, no need to make it like extremely accurate because we will be able to fix it with smear brush later. Now let's enable eyes, a smear brush, and let's adjust it a little bit around the eyes so it looks logical. Push it inside a little bit. Okay, starting to look better. So I'm not a professional artist, I do my best, but if you can do better, please let me know in the comments what I should improve. Okay, we'll use the smear button for the top part as well. Looks good. Okay, now I'm really happy with my eyes. And again, since the mirror was enabled, my another eye is also done. For the mouse, we'll basically do the same. You can hide teeth, make some straight lines. For cheeks, we can also extend some white area, removing some artifacts. And here's how my mouse and cheeks look after using just clone and smear brushes. Nothing else, just adjusted like the white area and eliminated some artifacts under the mouse. I also did a little bit touches on the legs, basically use smear to make it like a similar, because if we go back to texture and we activate material, again, shift control left button on the material and it will show it together with normal map. It actually messes a little bit with the texture. So let's go back to color. My final touch here will be to just remove these lines, because with normal map together, it contradicts. And I think I just don't need them here. You can paint them on top, but I will leave it for a normal map. So I'm gonna press Control Space, choose a paint brush, paint soft, and basically mark it at a one color. Okay, and here is our final result. When we finish that, don't forget to press Control Shift left button so we see the material. And when I adjusted the lines here, it looks just fantastic. And together with normal map, I can see all the lines. You can paint them more on top, but I don't want to do that right now. What else I can show you, that you can set up the materials such as roughness. So it was a bit too glossy. I wanted like less glossy, but let's say I want some specific part to be glossy and other no. You can also do that with texture painting in the following way. I give you like quick example how you can play with another maps. We're gonna press Shift A again, create another image texture. Let's press new roughness. We don't really need alpha, new image, amazing. Let's connect it to roughness, and one thing, let's make it non-color, because all maps except color should be non-color. Let's select it. Now what we're gonna do is to press Control Shift on this map. Here's what we see, it's just completely black map. We can select it here as well. And let's go to texture paint mode. We're gonna select paint brush, let it be paint soft. We're gonna extend the radius a bit. And here's the thing, if again we press on the material, you can see it's sort of like extremely roughness, because black color, it equals like zero roughness. And the texture is basically used as a value map. So if we go to roughness back, and let's say I will choose some colors like close to white. Here a value is basically equal to what roughness setting I want to apply on this area. And if I paint this area right now, let's make it like a little bit inaccurate. Control Shift on the material together. And now you can see that his belly is not that reflective as his body. The exact same thing you can do with the metallic. If we press this to metallic right now, you can see that this area is more metallic. If we put roughness a little bit down, we can see that this area is more metallic. Basically, metallic is like, it adds like self-coloring effect. Even this part started to be look like gold. Remember that if you press on the map here and you're in texture mode, you will be painting on the map that is selected here. So I can go and adjust this area right from here. I mean, the property I'm working with. And this is so amazing, right? So let's connect it back to roughness. Oops, sorry. And let's say I want to adjust this texture. Let's select what areas I don't want to be reflective, like that. And let's say I only want spikes to be reflective. I can paint area around with this value and keep this as a black, or basically the opposite. We can basically choose fill everything with this value, then go back and select like darker value, which will mean higher reflection. Go back to paint soft, and let's for example make his body reflective. By doing that, you can see here it is. How cool is that? But for now, I'll delete that map and just set the basic roughness to value like 0.75. And I want to show you one last and my favorite tool, that is called texture projection. We can use it with the stencil tool. So with projection, you can project textures, patterns, logos, text, anything. So I went to ChatGPT and created a logo of a dino. Okay, let's download that logo. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to texture menu here. We're gonna press new And in settings, we're gonna need to open that image. Let's open that image. Here we go. You can see this image here. While in texture mode, we're gonna go to texture. Instead of mapping toilet, we're gonna choose stencil. Now, as you can see, when I'm going to 3D view and I stop doing anything, there is a transparent texture. And with press over right mouse button, I can position it anywhere. I can continue to navigate as before, rotate the model. I can find the perfect viewpoint like this. Now, to control this image, we can use Control and right mouse button to rotate it, or Shift right mouse button to basically zoom it. It takes a little bit time to get acquainted, but later it will be extremely simple. And the final thing is that we can choose the brush as usual. Let's say I want paint hard brush. Okay, so in selected brush, let's select the bigger radius and basically paint on top. And here we go. It's actually wrong because I painted it on the wrong texture. Don't forget to select the texture you're working with. So just click on it here in the shader editor. Now in the color, make sure your color is set to white. Otherwise, it will override the color. And then we can basically paint on top of the projection like this. And here we go. We actually have a dragon with the right mouse button. I'll remove it. And here we can see we actually have a logo on our dino. And how cool is that? And that was extremely simple. You can paint with the projection anything. You basically can add tattoos. You can add garment on top like this. You can add one more. And look at this. It's just an amazing tool. Probably my favorite. You can add text, you can fix artifacts to that, you can add different patterns and so on. And the most important thing, when you're done editing texture, go to image and save it so you're not losing your efforts. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I really need your support. I really need to know if you like these videos to continue doing them. See you in the next one.